عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Everyone here, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, has an identity. Either one that was given to you, or one that you made for yourself. But everyone has one. In your pockets, you all have something that identifies you. In your physical bodies, you have something that identifies you. Some people know you by your voices, know you by your names, and by reputation, good or otherwise. But for those of us who say we take our religion from the Kitab and the Sunnah, and most of us say that, so what do you believe in? I believe in the Quran, and I believe in the Sunnah. That means that you and I have taken our identity from the Quran and from the Sunnah. How you identify me And how I identify you is supposed to come from the book and from the sunnah. And if it does not come from the book, and if it does not come from the sunnah, that lets you and I know how much work we have to do to get a proper identity. And to work from the base of that identity and not some other identity that was given or falsely earned. So one of the first identities, as you see me and I see you on this side of the masjid, the first identity, of course, is that we are men. So those who take their identity from the Quran and Sunnah and take their ideas and take their identification from the Quran and Sunnah identifies a man. And that is the identity that we have to know about so that we can fulfill it, because that identity of a man is the one that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and gains rewards and makes men happy. I'm going to quote from the end of a hadith, the one that starts At-tahuru shatr iman. Hadith by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. It starts by Anas ibn Malik. It starts At-tahuru shatr iman. At the end of the hadith, it says, كُلُّ نَاسٍ يَغْضُو فَبَاعِ نَفْسَهُ فَمُعْتِقُهَا أَوْ مُبِقُهَا. All men go out early in the morning and sell themselves. And by them doing this selling of themselves, they either free themselves by their own selling of themselves, or they destroy themselves by the way they sold themselves. I want to quote from Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, habibullah ta'ala, about this portion of the hadith. قال الشيخ فوزان حفظه الله تعالى الغدو هو ذهاب صباحا من البيوت. This word, الغدو, it means that you leave your house early in the morning. فالناس يخرجون من بيوت أول النهار. So the men or the people, they go out of the house in the first part of the day. أين يذهبون, he asks, where are they going? يَذْهَبُونَ إِلَىٰ عَمَالِهِمْ. They're going in the morning to commit some deeds. إِمَّا بَيْعًا, either they're going to sell. إِمَّا شَرَاءً, they're going to buy. إِمَّا وَظِيفَةً, or they're the employee of someone else. They have a contract and they're working. لَيْسَ هُنَاكَ أَحَدٌ يَجْلِسُ فِي الْبَيْتِ إِلَّا مَرِيضًا. At the first part of the day, is understood in Islamic society that the first part of the day, nobody is sitting at home unless he's a sick person or is a woman. A sick person or a woman. Nobody. In a Muslim society, and those of us who live in a Muslim society know that's the truth. First part of the day, everybody's out. All men out. All hands on deck. Time to get some things rolling, brothers. And nobody's home. Amma rajul. The Sheikh said who? Sick person or woman? He said, Amma rajul, فإنه يخرج ولا يبقى إلا إذا صار مريضا أو هرما. As for a man, he's out there. And nobody stays home unless he's sick or he's too old to do the deed of a man. Now there's some difference here now from what we know about. Some men squatting in the morning. As a matter of fact, after Fajr, the Salaf didn't even like to sleep between Fajr and sunrise. Some men sleeping. And you know sleep is akin to what? Death. The sun is risen and the man's half dead. Out cold. If you worked all night and you prayed Fajr, يعني معبر. الله تعالى أعلم. He has an excuse. وخروج العبد من بيته, and this slave going out from his house, إما أن يقعه في الشر. This one, when he goes at that house, is either going to put him in some kind of evil Or it's going to place him in a situation of goodness. One or two, brothers, sisters, we know it's true. Walk out that door, it's either a good walk or it's an evil walk. It's a good one or an evil one. Hence the hadith says, you sell yourself. How you sell yourself the first part of that day, you helped your own affair or you destroyed your own affair. No excuses about the slavery period and the bondage period. No excuses about how the society has done the black man. No excuses about that. Or excuses about this. And let's recall every year, let's all get depressed. Let's all cry about the slaves who got free in North Carolina and couldn't find their people. And. You did it. You either sold yourself, you helped yourself, or you didn't do it. Coming from the Sadaq al-Masduq, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From who? From the one who speaks lies. The Shaykh said, فَإِنَّ ذَهَبَ إِلَى طَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ If he's going to seek knowledge, with a fi'al ta'at, he's going to obey Allah, فَإِنُّ يَكْسِبُ خَيْرًا He's going to earn good. وَإِنْ ذَهَبَ إِلَى الْمَعَاصِ If he's going out to commit sin, and rebellion, and evil, and fitna, فَإِنُّهُ يَكْسِبُ شَرًّا That person is earning for himself sharr. Ibn Qadam al-Maqdisi said, Shar yani Adam. He is gaining for himself pain. He is making a house of pain. Spelled P-A-I-N. So what is the complete state of being known as a man? What is manhood? Because it is today, our societies are trying to make it a complex issue when in reality, if a person is paying attention to the book and the sunnah, it's not complex at all. Follows his book, follows his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And understand that the best men who ever lived in this ummah were the companions. And they used, radiallahu anhum, and they used to take all their religion from the book of the Sunnah, and there were no other books except those two sources of information. And they were the best men who ever lived, radiallahu anhum. Al-Rajul, who are axing mara, odidduha. Simple. A man is what opposes a woman. He is the opposite of her. Al-Rajul hu li yakhda batahu. وَنَفْسَهُ لِمِنْهَجِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ فَهْمًا وَصَرُوكًا A man is one who submits himself and his soul to the methodology set into motion by Allah عز وجل in his understanding and character. Begins with what? أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ Started there. Would you please move up? Everyone please move up. Because in the methodology that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set in place, in what He set in place, human beings are supposed to populate the earth the way He said to populate it, not the way they copied some wild person populating. It's supposed to populate the surface of the earth the way He commanded it be populated, just that way. Part of the khilafah is, it means khalf in ba'da khalf, jil ba'da jil, one generation after another. It's supposed to populate the earth in the way Allah wants it. If they take the populating in some other kind of way, inhabit the earth some other kind of way, they're going to fail. We are going to fail. Some signs of true manhood. Manhood requires a man to be diligent and consistent in his remembrance of Allah, Azza wa Jalla. And he is never over-occupied with this world so that he forgets the hereafter. Did not say he's not supposed to be occupied with it. Did not say he's not supposed to work in it. What does it say in Surah Al-Jumu'ah? وَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ And when the salah is over, go back into the earth. وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ Seek the bounty that Allah has placed on earth. Seek what He has submitted to you. The sun has been submitted to you, human being. He submitted the moon to you. The earth to you, the mountain to you, the calf to you, the cow to you, the sheep to you, the water to you. If you had not submitted it, you would not be able to use it. The gold he submitted to you, the oil in the ground to you, to use in his name. You won't use it, you're at fault. You won't seek it, you're at fault. You don't understand. Or you suffer from one of the two diseases. And Keslu, he is the one who can but won't. Lazy. He's the one who can't and don't care he can't. Doesn't have enough honor for his lamb to find out how to do the thing. Incapable. Lazy. Incapable. And among us are those who want to enjoy the fruits of being a man, too lazy to pick it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bi biyutin adina Allahu lahu an turfa wa yuzkar fiha ismu wa yusabbihu lahu fiha bi qudwi wal isal wal asal rijalun la tulhihim tijaratun wa la bay'un an dhikrillah wa iqamis salah wa ita'iz zakah يُخَافُونَ يَوْمًا يَتَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ قُلُوبُ وَالْأَبْصَارُ. Translation of which is, in houses, the masjid, which Allah has ordered to be raised, be cleaned, and be honored. In them, his name is remembered. Al-Yadan, remembered in Yaqama, remembered in the Salah, remembered in supplication, remembered in the recitation of the Qur'an. In these houses, he is glorified in the morning and in the evening. By men who neither trade nor sale or business divert them from the remembrance of Allah with hearts and the tongue, nor from performing a salah or giving the zakah. They fear a day when the hearts and eyes will be overturned out of the horror of the torment of a day of resurrection. This is a man in the religion of Islam. Manhood requires that a man put obedience to Allah ahead of his wealth and his son. Call Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Al malu wal banuna zinatul hayati dunya wal baqiyatu salihatu khayrun inda rabbika thawaban wa khayrun amala. Wealth and children are the adornment of the life of the world, but the good righteous deeds that last are better with your Lord for rewards and better to hope for. Wa qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, استكثروا من الباقيات الصالحات قالوا وما هن يا رسول الله قال التكبير والتحميد والتهليل والتسبيح ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله هي الباقيات الصالحات. Translation: occupy yourself with the abundance of the long-lasting good deeds. They asked, what are they, O Messenger of Allah? He said, Allahu Akbar, walhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, subhanallah, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. These are the long-lasting good deeds. Al-Imam al-Alusi, rahimahullah ta'ala, yaqulu fi tafsir hadhihi al-aya. Imam al-Alusi said in the tafsir of this ayah, al-amwalu wal-awlad sariha al-zawal. That money and children, they can vanish quickly. وَالذِّكْرُ اللَّهِ لَيْسَ كَدَارِكَ. The remembrance of Allah is not like that. وَالْمَالُ قَدْ يَكُونُ وِبَالًا. And money could have evil consequences upon the one who has it. عَلَى صَاحِبِي. لِكَثْرَةِ أَصْحَابِ الْحُقُوقِ. Why? Because when he held the money, people had rights to his money. He didn't give them their rights. He had all the money, and when you have a lot of money, understand, you're not just giving that money so you can just count it and spend it on yourself. But people have rights over your money. You're the caretaker of the money. Your wife has rights over your money. Your children have rights over your money. Zakah, the religion has rights over your money. The building of the masjid, you have rights. If there's no masjid, you have to help build it. The schools have rights over your money. The poor orphans have rights over your money in your society. We have women and children who live in homeless shelters. Why are women and children living in homeless shelters in America with all these strong men? Why? Because some of us have a selfish attitude toward ourselves. When we get it, first thing is some of my minds, I'm gonna get a car. Got a car. I'm gonna get a pretty car. You got a car. I'm gonna get another car. A car that makes people look at me and respect me. Put some rims on that thing. I can't see the rims, but everybody else is gonna see the rims when I'm driving. I can't see them, because it ain't for me to see. It's for everybody to see me. Look at me.
I'm somebody. I might be poor, but I'm somebody. And you won't see me because I'm going to do everything outrageous I can for you to see me. That's not the menhaj of this religion, brothers. Humility, seeking knowledge, and supporting what's pure and good. That's a man. Tucker Ruth Amin said, men don't wear gold because a man don't need a gold. You don't need gold. He said, it's a harm to wear gold. He said, all a man needs is his manhood. That's his beauty. Who a rajul? Who a rajul? Manhood is beautiful. Who a rajul? He's a man. You can take his word. You can count on him. He's honest. He's trustworthy. If he owes you money, he pays you money. He don't give you a story. Matlu ghani yadun. What's matlu ghani? That one who procrastinates in paying back a debt when he knows he owes. Meet me over here tomorrow. Meet me over there. Wait a minute. Don't meet me at all. I'll call you. Matlu ghani yadun. A man don't pretend he don't owe when he know he owe. A man's afraid he'll die and he'll owe. Men. A man. The sheikh said, he could lose his money. Or there's so many rights on that money when he got it, it's going to have evil consequences for him. He didn't give the rights. What did? Could your uncle, his son he's so proud of, this one could be disrespectful to him. Oh, yeah, said he could become perverted. He wouldn't be able to benefit from him. In either one. You couldn't benefit this world hereafter. Manhood requires that a man maintain qawama over his family and not surrender his qawama to anybody. He has qawama over his family and he will never surrender it. Not to anybody. Know what that is? You know what qawama is? You know what qawama is? All the loud talk, but do you have qawama? All the weightlifting, but do you have qawama? All the karate, but do you have qawama? Do you have al-qawama? That's the question. All the rest of that is just fluff and makeup if it's not backed up by a man's qawama. What is it? The Quran says, because we take our religion from the book and the sunnah, الرِّجَالُ قَوَّامُونَ عَلَى النِّسَاءِ بِمَا فَضَلَ اللَّهُ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ وَبِمَا أَنْفَقُوا مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ. Men are the protectors and the maintainers of women. Men are afdal from women. They say, you going to translate that? I want, sisters, let me translate it for the sake of argument. We are better than you. Let's say we're better than you. But the word is actually afdal. It means that your characteristics and our characteristics are different. And when you're looking for some way to carry forth the characteristics of the Ummah, to build the Ummah, our characteristics on the outside world are better than yours. Among them, al-razana, al-quwa, al-shuja'a. What's razana? Calm. Composed. Not loud, stupid. Not raising a voice and going out of character every 5 minutes. What you know? You know? What you know? F this, F that, F, 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 huh? That's a man? That's a man? Get a grip on yourself, Captain. Get a grip on him. Get a grip on him. Get a grip! That's a man. The color of your underwear is your business. Your underwear is your business, man. You gonna follow these homosexuals out here and drop your pants down and walk up and down the street with your pants down? Your underwear is your business. Whose business is it? What style? Style! Style! You done lost your mind. It looked like you lost. You're losing some other stuff too, man. I don't be funny. You follow that, you lost your mind. Don't lose your mind here. Trying to be cute. My mama used to say monkeys and babies are cute. Don't get punked out here trying to be cute to these girls out here. A man living to be twirled by a woman is a punk. I don't care what he says. Leading by the nose, holding onto his hand, walking down the street. That's a punk. I'm sorry. And you're just, I'm old either. That's a punk. If what you tell anybody, see, I got him, see. You got to straighten up. Follow the religion. If you're taking care of your business, you're taking care of your business. And your business is your business. Why men are protectors and maintainers of women? Because Allah has made one of them to excel the other one. And because they spend to support them from their means. Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah ta'ala, said, Al-Qayyim huwa qawwamuna, I, Ar-Ra'is. He is the president. People fight over leaderships and messages and are not the president in the house. Can you believe that? What is that? They fight over the presidency of the Jama'ah, find out my homeboy is the president of the household. I didn't want no trouble, cause I just went along with it. He is the one to be the president of everything else, but can't preside over his wife and family. Want to be the president of the gang, but can't preside over his children. That's false. That's riya. That's showing off. He's the president of the yahkum ahlahu. He's the one who directs his family. Awijajahum. And he straightens out when they're crooked. Either awiju. If they get crooked, he straightens them out. He don't get crooked first. He crooked. How's everybody, the man's crooked, how everybody supposed to be straight? He's crooked. I ain't got it. I don't have it. I don't know it. I ain't got it. I ain't got it. I don't have it. I don't know it. Who are mas'ul anhum yawman qiyamah? And he is the one responsible for them the day of judgment. Brothers, we must populate the earth where we've been commanded. Husband, wife, child. Not man, woman, child, marriage, other band. It's all backwards, brothers. You gotta straighten that out. It's all backwards. And if you do it backwards, if you're trying to live L-I-V-E, you do it backwards, it's E-V-I-L. Evil. Alhamdulillah, Ibn Alameen, wa salatu wa salam, ala Nabiyyina Muhammad.